Refer to question number 11. 11 says a compound C5H12O, this is the compound C5H12O, a compound C5H12O evolves hydrogen gas on reaction with sodium and reacts exothermally, that means it liberates a lot of heat on reaction with acetyl chloride. What is actually the compound? The compound is just this, and it answers the Lucas test immediately. Lucas test is one of the tests to identify the alcohol. If it liberates, if the reaction is very vigorous, it mixes with anhydrous zinc chloride and concentrated HCS instantaneously and forms turbidity immediately, then it shows that it forms, then it is a tertiary alcohol. It is actually given in the question, it answers, it gives an immediate Lucas test. That means it must be a tertiary alcohol. Another immediate thing is, it evolves hydrogen gas. Obviously, it is an alcohol, because one of the important tests for an alcohol on reaction with metallic sodium will liberate hydrogen. So, it is an alcohol, it is a tertiary alcohol. Based on the information that is given C5H12, it should only be just this compound. It is because it should contain 5 carbon atoms, it is a tertiary alcohol, so 2 methyl groups, the one additional extra 2 carbon atoms is accommodated in the form of an ethyl group. So, this should be one of the possible structures that can be given for the question number 11. So, the identify the compound A is the question asked. So, the compound A is just this. It is a tertiary alcohol. It answers the Lucas test immediately, and then being an alcohol, it reacts with acetyl chloride. It forms the acetyl derivative with a lot of liberation of heat exothermally. So, that is actually the reaction, and that is actually the question that is asked under the question and title under the number sequence 11. Now, let us go to question number 12. Refer to question number 12 in the series. Now, this alcohol is again given. This alcohol, as you know, is again a tertiary alcohol. It is a, what is a tertiary alcohol? A tertiary alcohol is one which is attached to 3 other carbons. One is here, the 2 other carbons are here. A tertiary carbon. So, that is what is known as a tertiary alcohol. This gives this product. The product is also given. When you look at the question number 12, identify the error in the following, that is the question that is asked. This compound gives this as the product. Actually, the answer is, this is not the correct product that is being obtained. I mean, that should be obtained. Obviously, the reason is the elimination, this is an elimination reaction. What is being eliminated here? A molecule of water is being eliminated in this compound. This OH and one other hydrogen atom gets eliminated, and it should be a beta hydrogen atom. That beta hydrogen atom can be lost from this group or from this group. If this is lost from the methyl group, it will give rise to a terminal olefin, which is not correct, because Seitzer rule says always a more substituted olefin is the product that is formed. If a more substituted olefin is formed, the product formed should be this CH3 double bond CH CH3, and not this. Therefore, this statement or the presentation of the question, namely 12, the product, that is the error in the product. The product that is given is not a Seitzer product. It goes against the, it violates the Seitzer rule. Therefore, the best product according to the Seitzer rule will be this product, which will be a more substituted olefin. This is a less substituted olefin. That is actually being indicated in question number 12.